Let's discuss the fourth problem in today's contest, which is weekly contest 304. It's called longest cycle in graph. So you're given a directed graph of n nodes from 0 to n minus 1. Each node is at most one outgoing edge. Graph is represented with a zero indexed array edges, indicating there's a direct edge from node I to node edges of I. Okay, so return the length of the longest cycle in the graph. If no cycle exists, then you have to return minus 1. Let's try to take our example, which we took in the problem 3, which we discussed. So same graph I have taken. Now in this you can see that as discussed already, that's a cycle of length 4, right? Why is it of length 4? It has 4 nodes. 1, 2, 3, 4. It has 4 nodes. That's why this is a cycle of length 4. Okay. How can we detect a cycle first of all? So it's very simple. Using DFS itself, you can detect a cycle. In the problem 3, we use DFS. We can use the same DFS code to detect a cycle. I'll tell you how, okay? You can start from any node which is reachable to the cycle, okay? Let's say I start from node 5, okay? So I am starting from node 5. The distance, in the last problem we discussed the distance array. Let's say the distance from node 5 to node 5 is 0. Distance from node 5 to node 3 is 1. Distance here is 2. Distance here is 3. Distance here is 4. Distance here is 5. Now when I visit this node, I will see that I can see that the distance is It's already visited, right? It's already visited, because here I can check that the distance is 2. But if I visit it, now I have to give it a distance of 6. Because after 5, I'm giving it a distance, I'll give a distance of 6. But I can already check either using visited array, okay? Or I can check if the distance is already a positive number. I can use anything. I don't want to complicate things. That's why I've used a visited array, right? So we can use a simple visited array. So you can check that this is already visited. This node was already visited. Current distance of this node, if I visited for the first time, it would have been 6. But the distance was, previously distance was 2. And the current distance is 6. 6 minus 2 is equal to 4, which is the length of the cycle, right? If I visited now, I am going to give it a distance of 6. But already somebody visited it for the first time and gave it a distance of 2. That means that there were 4 nodes in between this node, and again if I visited this node, that means the length of the cycle is equal to 4. Okay, so you can use this way to find the length of the cycle. From any node you can do a DFS, from any node which is reachable to the nodes in the cycle, right? So for example, I can do a DFS from node 4 also. I can again find out same algorithm. So the first distance is 0, this distance is 1, this distance is 2, this distance is 3. Again, if I visit, I would have given it a distance of 4. 4 minus 0 is equal to 4. So 4 is the length of the cycle. Okay, that's it. I can use a simple algorithm. So let's write the code and then let's see a little bit modification we will have to do, and we'll be able to solve this problem. So I can do the same thing, right? So I will start visiting for int I equal to 0, I less than edges dot size, I plus plus. Already we had declared the DFS function right here in our previous question. So I will use a simple same DFS function, and I can save time. So I am just copying the same DFS function. And what I'm going to do, I'm going to call the DFS, okay, and I'm going to pass the current node, and I can pass the, obviously I can pass the distance node vector, and I can pass the visited array. So I will have to declare these, I will declare them, and I will pass the edges array, and I will pass the initial distance, that will be equal to 0. Now in this code, when I'm doing this, what I can do, I can also check, right? So here what I did, I was checking these two conditions. Here also I'll just check these two conditions, but I will split these two conditions and I will check it. So what I'm going to do, the same if condition, I split it into two conditions. If it is not visited, I will continue as usual and I will call my DFS. But if it is visited, right? If it is visited, then what I can do, that means there's a cycle. If it is already visited, right? That means there is a cycle. So what I can do, I can just check what is the answer. Answer will be the length of this cycle. How I can find the length of the cycle? What is the current distance? The current distance is distance, right? In our example, in the first example that we took, let's take this example. This is the current distance. This is the distance, right? The distance is 4. And what is stored in the distance array? In the distance array, the distance that is stored is 0, right? So in the distance array, which is in our example, we are calling it distance node. So distance node for the node 4, we have stored 0, right? But the current distance is 4. So 4 minus 0, this is our answer, which is the length of the cycle, okay? So this is what we are doing. So distance minus whatever is stored in the answer of the current node, this is our answer. So answer has to be the maximum length of the cycle. So answer will be the maximum answer of the length of the cycle, okay? So this is the simple condition, okay? Now I can also declare these variables. So vector int distance node. I'll have to just quickly declare. I can also copy the declarations from here to save time, but it's okay. I'll declare them again. It's fine. So let me declare the visited vector. Initially it's having all values as false. I have the distance node vector, which is having edges dot size, and it is having it's of length edges dot size. Initially the distance is 0. Okay, and I also have to declare an answer. Initially answer I'm going to make it as -1, and I'm going to change my answer as and when I find the correct answer, right? Is there anything else that I need to declare? I don't think so. I also need to pass this answer variable here. So let me also pass this answer variable here. Okay, so in the DFS call, I'm also going to pass this answer variable. And finally, what I can do, I can return answer. Okay, by the way, when we are making the DFS call, what we can do, we'll make the DFS call only for the nodes that are not visited. Okay, there is no point in making the DFS call if you have already visited the nodes. If you have not visited the node, then we can make the DFS call. Okay. Now there's one problem. This code will not work. I mean, we have to modify it a little bit. Why it will not work? I'll give you an example where this code will not work. So what will happen? This code is okay, but see, when you have a condition like this, let's say I have nodes like this, what will happen in this? There is no cycle, right? So what should be the natural answer? The answer should be -1. Okay, but what will happen is, let's say we start DFS call from this node. Initially the distance is 0, the distance is 1, the distance is 2. We have visited these nodes and this part is done. Okay, this part is done. Now again, when I'm making the DFS call, what I will do, I'll make the DFS call from the next node which is not visited, right? So when I'm making the DFS call for node 0, I'm visiting only 3 nodes. So some nodes are left which I'm not visiting. So in the next DFS call, for example, I'll start from node 3 and I'll start the DFS call. I will see, I'll mark this distance as 0, and this node, when I check in my visited array, these all nodes are marked true. These all nodes are marked true. So I will think that this node has already been visited and I'm visiting it again. So even for this node, what I'm going to do, even for this node, I will think that there is a cycle. My algorithm is not intelligent enough to detect that these two are two different DFS calls. Currently, what my algorithm is doing, it is just checking if in the visited array the nodes are true. It is true. It is true in the visited array. So I will think that there is a cycle, but actually in this example, there is no cycle. So what is the problem with our algorithm? Is our algorithm can be used to find cycles in an undirected graph, but for a directed graph, it will fail, because if a node is already visited, what it will do, it will think that there is a cycle, but even though there is no cycle. So how do we modify our algorithm? Okay. So to modify our algorithm, we have to use visited array. Okay. We can also use one extra array to find out if in the same DFS call we are detecting a cycle. What was our problem? In two different DFS calls we were detecting the cycle, but still our algorithm was thinking that, I mean, in two different DFS calls we were detecting the same node and we were thinking that it is visited, but actually there were two different DFS calls. Our algorithm was not able to differentiate between both. So to differentiate between two different DFS calls where there is no cycle, right, when there is no cycle, we want our algorithm to show that there is no cycle. So we can use one extra array. Okay, now let me try to tell what I'm telling in simple terms. So let's say that this is our, okay, this is our cycle. We have to detect cycle in this algorithm. So what we can do, we have visited array, okay, we have visited array, and we have one extra array. Okay, we have an extra array. So let's consider for example this simple case when there is a cycle. So I'll just write the nodes 1 2 3 4 1 2 3 4. Already we have discussed the condition to check the length of the cycle. We will not discuss it again. I'm just trying to tell how to detect cycle right now in this part. So first what we'll do, corresponding to the node 1, let's say we are starting DFS call from node 1. So in node 1 we'll mark true in the visited array and in the extra array. In node 2 we'll mark true in the visited array and in the extra array. In node 3 we'll mark true in both the places. In node 4 we'll mark true in both the places. And from node 4 we'll try to visit node 1. We will check that it is already visited in both the visited array and in the extra array. That is why there is a cycle here. So we can detect there is a cycle using simple extra array. Okay, so let's see how our algorithm is going to work in case there is no cycle, right? How it will work correctly. So we have our visited array and we have our extra array, right? So in this case there is no cycle, so it should return that there is no cycle. Okay, so we have 4 nodes, 1 2 3 4 1 2 3 4. So let's say we start the DFS call from node 1 in the visited array and in the extra array, I'm going to mark it as true. In the node 2, in the visited and extra array, I'll mark it as true. In the node 3, in the visited and extra array, I'll mark it as true. Okay. Now this DFS call is finished because 3 has no neighbors, right? So when this DFS call is finished, right, what I'm going to do, when I'm backtracking, when I'm going back from this node, in the extra array, I can mark it as back as false. Okay. Now again, when I'm going back in the extra array from here, I can mark this as false, right? And again, I can mark this as false. Okay. So this for one DFS call only, I'll mark it as true. After the DFS call is finished, I'll mark it as false. Okay. Now in the, for the next DFS call, for the next DFS call, I will start from node 4. So from the in the node 4, in the visited and in the extra array, I will mark it as true. Then I will go to node 2. In the visited array, even though it's already true, but in the extra array it is false, right? So this is not a cycle, so I can be sure from here, because if it was a cycle, both in the visited and in the extra array it would have been true. But here you can see that in the extra array it is false. That means I'm not visiting this node again in the same DFS call. Okay, in the same DFS call I'm not visiting this node. I would have, maybe I visited this node in a previous DFS call, that is why it is true, but it doesn't matter. There is a cycle only when I'm visiting the node again in the same DFS call. But in this case, what I'm doing, I'm seeing that in the extra array it is false. That means there is no cycle. So our algorithm is working perfectly. It is telling us that there is no cycle. Please don't consider it as a cycle. So in the extra array, I will mark it as true after I visit this node, and from here I will exit. Okay, from here I will exit, and when I'm exiting again, I'll mark these two values as false after this DFS call is finished. So in this way, what I can do, I can check whether I have a cycle or not. So we can just use one extra array and I can check. So that's it. So let me declare an extra array, vector bool extra array. And it is also going to be edges.size, and it is also going to initially take the values as false, right? It's going to take the values as false initially. So here I can just modify the code a little bit, right? So here I can check if in the extra array, if the node is also true, if in the extra array also it is true and in the visited also it is true, that means what is happening is there is a cycle. So here I can just give one extra line. If in the extra array the node is visited, that means it's true. Okay. So if it is true, that means there is a cycle, right? So this is what I can do. And by the way, in each DFS call for the extra array also, initially we can make it as true, just like we do for the visited array. And after the DFS calls are finished, what we can do, in the extra array we can mark them as false. Okay, that's it. This is the simple additional bit of code. This algorithm can be used to detect cycle in indirected graph. Indirected graph, you need to use an extra array. In undirected graph, you need not use an extra array. Okay, so that's it. So I will pass one extra parameter, which I can call as extra itself. Okay, so that's it. Hopefully that this should work. Let me run and see if it is working. There's some compilation error. Okay, here it is called distance node of 1. Let me run and see if it is working. It's working. Let's submit and see if it's working for all the test cases. So it's working. Thank you for being patient and listening. And by the way, the time and space complexity is order of n.